Right, so imagine this situation. You are working on this project here, which is open here in this SDL studio. And let's say, for the sake of argument, this project is just in this French into Czech combination. And I'm actually working in this French language. So it means this kind of French that is spoken in France. So this is a project where I'm translating from French into Czech. But the problem is that I would like to attach a translation memory, which is in this Canadian flavor of French, which we have right here. So now, if I wanted to attach such a memory to this project, I would just do it here. And so let's try to do that. And as you can see, this SDL studio will show this error. It will just say that the translation provider does not support any language pair in this project or project template. And as you can probably imagine, this can be a real pain because, well, frankly speaking, I am translating into Czech and I am translating from French. And I don't really care that much if this French is this French, or if it's a Canadian French, or if it's some African French. It's basically to me just to French. And I know there are some differences in Canadian French as compared to French. They have a slightly different vocabulary, but you know, I am translating this project into Czech, so I don't really care, and I would very much like to attach this Canadian translation memory to my project, but I can't because the SDL studio will just prevent me from doing so. And this is kind of annoying. So in this video, I would like to show you what can you actually do in this kind of situation. And as you can imagine, the solution is pretty much simple. I actually wrote my own tool to do this. This tool is called Bohemicus. It's a very comprehensive tool for translators. It can do many things, especially translation, machine translation, voice dictation, and many features to improve your translation productivity. And one of them is just changing the translation memory settings. So what I can do with this Canadian French translation memory is that I can just right-click it and I can choose this change SDLGM properties. And it will open this dialog window where I can actually change the source language and the target language of this translation memory. So as you can see, currently there is this Canadian flavor of French selected. So I can just simply change it to French. So the French spoken in France. And I just click change and that's it. And as you can see, now I can add it to my project, no problem. And as you can see, it's been successfully added. Right, so we have successfully attached our translation memory to our project. And now I would like to show you what's actually under the hood, what's actually behind the scenes. So an SDL translation memory is actually an SQLite memory version 3. So if you want to actually view your translation memory, you can do that also in this special tool, which is called DB Browser for SQLite. This tool is completely free of charge, so you can download it from the internet and you can install it onto your computer. And once you have done so, you can actually drag and drop your translation memory onto this tool. And it will actually show you the structure of this translation memory database. And what we are especially interested in is this translation memories table. And as you can see, when you click it, it will show you the structure of this table. And now what we are also especially interested in is this source language and target language items. And if you want to change these properties right now, then you can just click on this view data. I'm sorry, my tool is in Czech, so I'm just translating it on the fly. So this means view data. And you also choose your translation memories table. And as you can see here, we have it with all these properties. So now, if I want to change it from this Canadian flavor of French, I can simply do it here. I can click it. And I could change it to whatever I wanted. So let's change it to French, which is FR-FR. And you just click on Write Changes. And that's it. Your translation memory has been changed to French. You can check it. You can check it using the Bohemicus tool that it's been really changed to French. So it means this kind of French spoken in France. And as you can see, it's here. So this is how you can very easily and quickly change the translation settings, the source and target language of your SDL translation memory.